JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's Daily Market Review for September the 24th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, Head of Research here at JFD, that will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded lower against all but one of the other major currencies on Thursday during the Asian session Friday. It lost the most ground versus NZD, AUD and CAD, while it gained only JPY. The weakening of the US dollar and the Japanese yen combined with the strengthening of the commodity-linked currencies Kiwi, Aussie and Loonie suggests that financial markets continued trading in a risk-on fashion yesterday and today in Asia. Indeed, looking at the performance in the equity world, we see that all but one of the major EU and US indices traded in positive territory, perhaps still due to investors' relief that China's Evergrande would have undergone some bond payments on Thursday. The only exception was the UK FTSE 100, which finished 0.07% down, perhaps due to the outcome of the Bank of England, which we will discuss in a while. Having said all that, though, risk appetite softened during the Asian trading today, as Thursday passed without any official announcement for Evergrande on any potential payments. Now, in our view, this revived fears over a potential default, with the developer now having 30 days to settle payments scheduled for yesterday, with more payments due in the days to come. All this confirms what we said yesterday and the day before, that the default risks are far from vanished. We continue to believe that the Evergrande saga will keep market participants on the edge of their seats. Even if the company starts negotiating a restructuring agreement with its creditors, anything pointing to such a deal being handled poorly could result in more concerns. Therefore, we cannot rule out further setbacks in equity markets in the short run. Now, back to the FX sphere, the commodity-linked Aussie, Kiwi and Loonie were the main gainers, as we already saw. But the next gainer in line was the British pound, which was lifted by a more hawkish than expected Bank of England. The bank kept all its policy settings unchanged, but in the statement accompanying the decision, it appeared more confident with regards to interest rates. Officials repeated that some modest tightening of monetary policy over the forecast period was likely to be necessary, but added that some developments appear to have strengthened the case. What's more, officials agreed that any future initial tightening should come in the form of a rate hike, even if that becomes appropriate before the end of the existing government bond purchases. Another hawkish tilt was that Sanders was joined by Ramsden in supporting a halt in the bank's purchases now. So all these signals may have been more hawkish than market participants may have been anticipating, and may have encouraged them to bring forth their rate hike bets. Indeed, according to Reuters, after the Bank of England's statement, sterling interest rate futures priced in a 90% chance for a hike by February, up from just over 60% before the event. The pound jumped higher on the outcome, and it may continue to gain for a while more, as all this suggests that the Bank of England may become the first major central bank to lift interest rates since the COVID pandemic. However, such a likelihood quickly priced in, We will carefully monitor upcoming economic data and developments, as any disappointments could prompt investors to scale back their hike bets and thereby push the British currency down again. Now, as for today's events, during the European session, the German IFO survey for September is coming out, while later from the US we get the new home sales for August. With regards to the IFO survey, the current assessment index is expected to have inched up to 101.8 from 101.4, while the expectations one is anticipated to have slid to 96.4 from 97.5. This is likely to take the business climate index down to 98.9 from 99.4. New home sales are expected to have increased fractionally. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, a greater weekend, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again next week.
JFT, just fair and direct.